Hey guys, press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Pink Villa.
Hello guys, it's a beautiful Saturday and that brings us to this week's best and worst of television. Television undoubtedly caters to a wide audience and our TV stars become household names instantly. With fashion getting into every space, our small screen actresses are leaving no stone unturned in looking their very best. So let's see who was the best and worst dressed of TV this week. The gorgeous Jennifer Wingate sure did have a reason to celebrate as the talented actress won the Dadasaheb Phalke Award. Jennifer kept it minimal yet looked really elegant. She donned a powdered blue plain sari and teamed it up with a high-neck net blouse with tiered frills on it. Side-parted sleek hair with a bronze undertone makeup, nude lips and statement earrings finished off her look. Next, we have Riddhi Dogra. She donned a mustard yellow lehenga with silver embroidery work on it and teamed it up with an olive green net dupatta. However, we think that the silver neck piece wasn't needed and the blouse could have had a better fitting. But her makeup and hair were all on point. Rubina wore a white lace sari and teamed it up with a plunging neckline batwing sleeve blouse which had a ruffle detail on it. Pullback hair in a ponytail with thick filled in eyebrows, nude undertone makeup and dangler earrings punctuated her look. Divyanka Tripathi is next and she wore a floor length gown which had a golden bodice with fringes on it and cuff sleeves with kundan stone decorations. The bodice had an attached white tulle skirt with a flouncy effect. Hair pulled back in a high ponytail with pink undertone makeup, red lips and drop earrings finished off her look. Honestly, the bodice looks a little too OTT and her hair and makeup do not go too well together. We have Divyanka again and thanks to her Instagram post, we have this really cute look. The Ye Hai Mohabbate actress wore a pastel pink floral midi dress which was fitted till the knee and had attached tiered tulle flare effect. The sleeves too had 3/4 belt sleeves. Pinkish nude ballets with minimal makeup, hair tied in a side pleat finished off a happy vibrant look. Gauahar Khan is next as she donned an indigo and white printed kurta with a high-low silhouette. She teamed her kurti with basic blue denim jeans and tan flats. Filled in brows with blush pink makeup, brown lips and hair left open finished off her look. The kurta and the denims don't really go well together and the handbag looks a little off. Next up, we have TV's stunner Anita Hassanandani as she looked absolutely breathtaking in a black cross-neck bodycon bandage dress with a center cutout. Anita opted for a sleek side bun, silver drop earrings and bracelet. Thick eyebrows and pink undertone makeup completed her look. We sure did experience a very stylish week and we cannot contain our excitement for the next. Do comment and let us know which look was your favorite. If you like this video and want more of these, please like, share and subscribe to Pink Villa.